aren't in the whole founding nations
is going to help them.
Is going to help them a lot.
I wonder how long it's going to be until someone breaks and just buys them outright. Okay, so Rosalia doesn't like her, Chris doesn't like her, and Hilda doesn't like her.
Of course.
The three bitches. Please answer the question. Wow. You don't even know. She's an AI. You know, to be honest, that's kind of fucked up for her to say with, like, how half this cast is.
Mm-hmm.
Especially Setsuna, Alleluia, I'm assuming Sosuke.
Yeah, Sosuke's definitely still going for Child Soldier. Because this is second... This is second raid.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
He's still not done his shit yet. He's further in it, but he's not through it.
Yeah, I mean... He's at least in a much better place mentally now, I think. Considering he's got so many people looking after him.
Let's see, you mech with us. Let's finish tuning the Arblast. I want to get Arblast to 50.
Yes.
Nah, I'm just barely. So after the next mission, as long as I hit, what's it called? It should be good. You know, if I hit another, yeah. I just want to make sure I don't override my, practice file.
Check on the scores of the Braves.
Here, there we go. 6. You know. 17. Let's see.
16, 17, 14, so that's roughly 45 total.
Yeah. 47.
47? Okay.
Well,
do you want to know something?
I'm guessing, based on the fact it says sub-scenario instead of next scenario, I'm guessing this is one of the route splits Tristan mentioned?
Yes.
Okay,
If you go the Japan route, upcoming, try to get a grand total of 50. That's not gonna be hard, because...
Yeah, they're really close.
If you had reached 60... before clearing 14, you would have already reached the requirement. Because you would have been able to get secret scenario earlier.
Wow, they're being some... I wouldn't say they're being petty, but still. Oh, God. I think she's gone unhinged.
Hmm.
Gone a little unhinged.
Obviously.
Hmm.
ATAT.
Aw. She's trying to help. She wants to actually use some cool formation.
She's trying.
Fine. And Jet wants nothing to do with it.
I mean,
This team is
in such a bad place.
It's so dysfunctional.
Yeah, that from what I've read from TV Tropes, they've got Dysfunction Junction as one of their tropes, and that's never good.
I mean, granted, like, this isn't like a thing of like, oh, it's dysfunction because like they just don't get it along. It's like, no, she got their commander killed. And two kids. There is some understandable animosity between them.
Yeah.
Her initial introduction also did not help. Yeah, she does. I'm not there. I don't blame her for not trusting them. They will shoot. They all need to work their shit out. And she wants her to die so she can get the Mac. We're splitting up. Okay. But we need a buffer against the dragons, so we're gonna keep half the force here, and the other half is gonna go to Japan.
More firepower from the Rakiors, including the Zenon.
Yeah. So the ones who are staying are going to be Celestial Being and Mithril.
Yeah, makes sense.
You know what? I'm debating on staying just because I want to see how because I'm assuming Noriega wants to stay because I want to see if she can whip this team into shape. And I also want to see more of the Full Metal Panic crew.
I understand that.
Yeah.
If you go to the Japan route, you will be able to get another Brave unit.
Is it the one that requires the kill count?
Yes.
The ones who are going...
You play your way, though.
I know, I was going to say, the ones who are going to be going back to Japan are the Brave Express Corps, Tobia, so X Crossbone Gundam, Hathaway, and Judao.
Yeah, it won't look out of place for Gundam to be in Japan, regardless of the type of Gundam.
Yeah, it makes sense why Celestial Being would also want to stay here outside of anything else, because... Here, they're not actively being sought after by the government.
Decide your route.
Let's flip the coin. Heads, I will stay in Arsenal. Tails, I go to Japan. Heads, it is! We're staying in Arsenal. I can always do, like, at least in terms of getting the other unit, I could do it on another run.
Yeah, do another run when you get the chance.
What I might end up doing for this project is, after we complete one playthrough, I will, you know, start a new game plus and go the other routes.
Play mail.
Yeah. I might do that. Like, just, like, do it completely. Because, like, there are some areas where there's going to be four different stories going on.
Yeah. I will mention, male and female do get different mid-scenario upgrades.
Really?
Apparently.
I'm guessing they prioritize different things. Can I venture a guess just based on the personalities?
I honestly don't know. I just know that they have that there are two different names listed for the upgraded version of the Vanray.
Yeah, so it's either gonna be I'm gonna be allowed to choose, or it's based on gender. I'm assuming gender.
I'm assuming that 9 would modify it to suit the personality of the user.
Yeah.
At least that's what I'm thinking. Also, gonna note that 9 seems to be interacting a bit more with people.
I actually like that. The 9, we get a little bit of 9 interacting with them, trying to learn.
Yeah.
So the units who have left us, so the units who are staying with us are Sumeragi, Tessa, Setsuna, Lakon, Alleluia, Teria, Sosuke, Mao, Cruz, Colossia, Ange, Salia. I don't know what the EV stands for, actually. I just noticed that.
EV.
You notice that on, like, my unit and Ange's?
Yeah.
I'm Googling it. Maybe
it's events.
Maybe?
I don't know.
Here we go. Okay. Okay, so no, that just means they will be automatically deployed every so often.
Okay.
So it's kind of like...
Story locked.
Story locked ones. This one does it more than, say, 30 does with the, the announce, like, because every unit can have it in, almost every unit can have it in 30.
Right.
Ooh. And we don't know where the Vilk is. Oh, they're talking about murdering this girl, and look who's right there. Yeah, this is mission. This is gonna be scenario 15. This is gonna be our last one for the night. Mm-hmm. I will say, going in the future, these streams will not be nearly as long. It's just I need the backlog.
Right.
Nothing poisons the well like hatred.
Humans are such tragic creatures. Yeah.
Yeah, we are. Oh, this must be her. Oh, her sister was wheelchair bound, I think. Oh god, not this scenario again. I've seen this scenario. This is called Gundam Seed. This is how Atherin met Kigali. Like, I shit you not, this is pretty much the same scenario that led to them meeting. Oh no. He's trying to save her life. And, okay, look, all memes and jokes aside, he actually did the right thing in terms of, like, trying to save her life.
Yeah.
Leaving her in wet clothes could kill her.
Yeah, she would freeze to death.
This is just anime syndrome, it seems. Ooh!
Yeah. Yeah, From what I've gathered, Tusk gets abused a lot.
I take it he's got the accidental anime syndrome, but overall he's an honest kid.
I don't know. But somebody does try a ball buster on him. Like, on screen.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, in terms of Gundam Seed, that was how Atherin met Kigali, and basically told Kira, I'm gonna steal your sister. I shit you not, Atherin and Kira's love life is actually hysterical, because Kira steals his fiance and Atherin steals his sister. It's kind... Granted, Kira didn't know it was his sister. She's legitimately confused as to why we are worried about Anja's state of being. Like, worried that she's alive. God, these girls have a fucked up life.
Yeah. And of course, Kurz.
Yeah.
Good thing Sesuke's right there to tell him, shut up.
Yeah. Oh, they're actually talking about it! They're talking about Alleluia! That's sort of the best thing with Alleluia and the rest of the Celestial Being crew. Even after he comes out and he tells them his full story, they don't treat him any differently.
Mm-hmm.
Which is funny, because very few... Actually, I don't think any
of... And then there's Kurz here. Try to accept rather than discriminate and hope for the same from others.
Yeah.
Kurz is... Yes, he is a pervert. He's the chivalrous pervert archetype.
Yeah. I will say this, I don't think they're going to talk about him. Alleluia has another side named Hallelujah. He's batshit insane. Like, the way they describe it is when they rewired his brain to be a super soldier, one side is reason, the other side is instinct.
Ah.
The issue is it manifested as a completely volatile personality. Meanwhile, they had to basically repress Maria Parsavi to allow another her form called Soma Cruz to take full control, and then they made her a loyal soldier. Soma Cruz was just pure instinct, but there was no reason behind her movements. When Alleluia and Halleluia worked together towards the end of Season 1, which is instinct and reason in perfect sync, they could not touch him. Like, this suit was missing an arm and a leg, and he took down 3 more of their mobile suits before he went down.
Yep.
Due to a lucky shot.
Shut up, Hilda.
Yeah, she won't.
My God.
I have a feeling. Fuck off. Oh, and Nines is. What did you do? There are the weak links. How the fuck did she stop it so... Like, did she sabotage this mech so fast? I mean, granted, it must be... I'll be honest, thinking it out, it actually could be pretty easy with how complex some of these machines are. One loose bolt. Even Sosuke's just like, no, just don't stoop to their level. Ooh, they've contacted someone from the outside?
Hmm.
Wait. Who else could they have contacted? They stuck underwear in the exhaust port. You know what? I'll give them props for creativity. Can we just at least give them props for creativity?
Yeah.
Yeah. Cause the engine to overflow and inhibited flight. I'm just Tusk, nothing more. He is a simple man. I bet I'm on vacation.
Can't use mana, but there are no mail. Nor, what are you doing on this side?
I am just Tusk. I can't tell you how many times I was hit, wrapped up, and almost killed. It's all your fault. He did that to save her life, he tripped, and... I took your clothes off because you were wet, I touched your chest to keep you warm, and the rest was only because I tripped and fell. You know what, actually, in all honesty, at least with the first two, he probably saved her life.
Yeah, but... Like,
I could get it.
The remainder is 100% anime syndrome.
Yeah. Oh, and then this one. Okay, you know what? Okay, this is actually misinformation.
Yeah.
But it's very common misinformation. This was like an old thing people used to do all the time. An old method a lot of people used to talk about to get out snake venom was to suck it out. Don't do that. You're just poisoning yourself.
Yeah.
But I can't hold that against them because of the fact that is like that wasn't accepted.
Such a commonly used misinformation that it's really hard.
Yeah, it's stuck around for years.
Yeah.
Oh, he's just straight up calling her out. Oh, that's nice. He's offering her his island.
I mean, it's not a bad idea. Probably get treated better here.
I don't know. Maybe if she interacts more with the, casts we've got. I mean, it's not like this cast could get any... crazy.
More bloated.
Fuck! It had to be this guy. Our first introduction to the next series.
Hi, Atheron.
Atheron Zala, this poor man. Wait, Tusk knows Atheron? Oh, so this is where the Kigali incident happened.
Hmm.
Does this mean I'm returning the favor? How the tables have flipped and destiny has revealed itself.
I intrude upon him and some girl in the cave.
Okay, so yeah, he's Orb at this point. So if he's Orb, And assuming that since the second war happened with the outlaws, that would mean his mobile suit should be the Infinite Justice.
Hmm.
He seems to know something about- Wait, when did you tell him the name of the suit was the Velkis? Or Velkis? I think he knows something. A couple dragons.
Maybe she mentioned it while they
were... True, during the time skip.
Yeah, we don't know.
Yeah.
Because we never watched the series.
Probably won't. This doesn't... While I can appreciate the mech design, it doesn't strike me as my kind of show.
Yeah.
I have that with a few of them. I could appreciate the overall designs and some of the atmosphere. I just could not get into them.
Tusk, what are you doing?
Holy shit, he... The... What?
Oh, that was Ange.
No, it wasn't even Ange, it was the mech. It did it on its own. And we're back in action.
Huh.
There he is! Atherin Zala in Infinite Justice. Seeing the color of your craft makes me sick to my stomach. Poor Atherin. Atherin gets so much shit.
It's the same color as Hilda's.
I know, but a lot of people... Atherin has a interesting life. 3 enemy units, 1 ally pilot in a single turn. Ooh, that's a little tricky. Actually, no, wait. Counters. Okay, now comes the real question. Infinite Justice, Shining Edge. Now comes the real question. What track did they use with the C/C Destiny characters?
By the way, Nick.
They used Ignite. I'm happy. I'm sorry, what?
By the way, Kira and Atherin have a combination attack.
Good, they should. Ignite is such a good song. I love this. Like, as much as I have problems with C/C Destiny, their music is fucking amazing. Ooh, variable phase shift. Yeah, I know, because some of their attacks are melee. His phase shift armor would deflect it. I'm going to keep her out of this for now. Just because I would like to see if I could get Atherin to get the counters. Oh, I see, because it's on a higher level. I like this music. I like this mix of Ignite more. Ooh, nice combo. Shield and the... Oh shit, and my switch fell over. That is the second time that has happened this time. Ooh, she's got a new technique. Charge. I think she's starting to enjoy fighting to live. Oh, it's a motorcycle cockpit!
Oh, hell yeah.
I love those kinds. You don't see them that often. The big one I know of is Code Geass.
Yeah.
The Gurren.
Actually, the motorcycle cockpit probably fits better since it can transform into a plane mode.
Yeah. Atherin gets the first attack. One. Off just using the beam saber, going for the guaranteed kills. So that third one attacks him, I've got this SR challenge in the bag. God, the only issue I have with the phase shift armor, it's fucking eating away at his energy supply.
Hmm. Oh, apparently you could get the Grungus in Hookbane, like, really early.
Yeah, they were, yeah, that's the same with the other ones. There's some early missions for a bunch of the characters, but... Your Paramount also reminds me of my friends. One that resembles the Vilkis. White body and blue wings, and a similar fighting style. Fucking Jesus Yamato. Wait, excuse me? What are they doing here?
Huh.
I'm just allowed to deploy everything. You're not helping Hilda's distrust of men by talking like that, you know. God, they're teaching... Mao's teaching Nine how to keep people in check. No need to hold back if it's a machine.
Seem more motivated.
I have a feeling our commanders are going to, like, one of the two commanders. Which one do you think is going to snap first, Tessa or Sumeragi? I'm leaning towards Sumeragi.
I could see Tessa. I could see Tessa snapping too.
Yeah. They don't possess the same sense of justice as the Braves. Comparing them is blasphemy. As I would like to move all my forces forward, I'm gonna wait to see if I can get the three in one turn. Well, weaken them to the three in one turn. Because if I could do that, then I'll have enough money to hopefully get the custom park for the Albrice, which I'm assuming is probably gonna boost his engine. Wow. That is
impressive.
Yeah. Very flashy.
Incredibly so.
Go for the guaranteed kill. Hit this one with another anti-tank, well, with an anti-tank dagger, so it'll make it easier for her to get the kill. I still love the anti-tank dagger animation, it's just so goofy. On the safe side. Oh! I mean, I'm not surprised Atherin has that, but I'm surprised it triggered already. I thought the seed effect was going to be, story locked for a bit. That should put it at number 3. There we go! Now I can move everyone in.
Bingo!
You failed me, you didn't get the kill. Is that a 9-barreled rocket launcher? I think Nemesis is jealous.
Stars?
Mine only has 4.
Not surprised. Oh my god, she's running out of energy. Well, thankfully, she's got an assault rifle that has ammo instead of energy reserves. I will say, if I do get a choice in Vanguard upgrades, I'm gonna go with whichever one is gonna give me the most goddamn firepower. Focus 117, and he needs no. Oh, it's a mech piece. There it is. 130, so he's got a little bit before that engine activates. Okay, so he's already at, now he's at 120. Okay, so he gets a decent bit from that. I will say, the one thing that's throwing me off coming off SR30, I'm so used to being able to just buy Hit and Run from the start. I like actually have to work towards throwing me off a little bit. Especially because I'm more interested in investing my attack points into upgrading 9 or more. There we go, we finally used the Urge Strike now that I've got the three of them together. Yeah, so it does have a dynamic change if the engine's working, okay.
I appreciate those details.
Yeah, I can love that. I love that little detail. It's kind of like the dialogue boxes with Suzaku in R30. Like the fact that if the Curse of Geass is active, he actually gets the red rings, like the red irises. Like, they didn't have to do that. But the fact that they did it is a nice touch.
Ooh, Nick.
Yeah?
Nick. That attack point bonus that Mike gets.
Yeah?
It becomes double if he's ace.
Okay, so I gotta get him 50 units, or, 60 units and proud ace. Is that the annoying thing about that is it has to be 60 units for him by himself.
Not to mention, it's the Mind Gun already has two pilots without any damage.
I don't believe it doubles his score, is the sad thing.
What?
Wait, my guy's score for Ace?
No, it does. I don't know, but.
Finally, last enemy. But Atherin has all those EX points. I might as well use them. Ooh, and the Phantom O1's ready. Oh, she's gotta say bye to Tusk. And she also said thank you. It's growing.
Oh.
It looks like she's grown a little bit.
Send you a message. Read it when you get the chance. You don't have to read it on stream.
So, thanks to my ability, I've gained 80 bonus tack points and 4,503 extra money.
Nice.
This is gonna pay for itself. Okay, so I see. Thank you for letting me know about that.
Yeah. There's others if you want to know about them.
I think I only want to use one. I don't want to use like a bunch of those.
Okay.
Because that I feel like it's snowball out of control really fast.
Yeah, this is listed in the category of disc one nuke. So, yeah.
Yeah. Because yeah, this would be the equivalent of it. I think we're still only in like chapter two.
Yeah, we're still technically in disc one.
Yeah, I think this is a 7-chapter game. This one has as many units as, say, 30 does. And it also definitely doesn't hit as many series. You know what? That could be both.
I'm Tusk. Nothing more.
Yep, just Tusk. Simple man. Yeah, because 30 hits a lot of characters, but it's because with a lot of those characters, their stories are done, and they're just there to kind of share wisdom with the new pilots.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? I think works very well. Because, you've got, well, pretty much all the Gundam cast helping Uso and, Jonah with their issues.
Yeah.
Everything with Gridman.
Literally everything with Gridman.
I will still say I like the interactions with the Braves and the Gridman Alliance. Then there's the weird, like, the weird relationship between Lelouch and Vaughn that I didn't think I needed. And then Suzaku helping Kid from Knights of Magic become a better knight.
Yes.
That just felt, that felt fitting for Suzaku. Nothing happened on this island. Nothing was seen, nothing was touched, and nothing was sucked. You know, out of context, that could sound really bad.
Yeah.
I think he knows the significance of this machine. Wait, she complimented Setsuna's voice. Oh, come on. I don't know, are they shocked that they were just called out by Atherin? We're back to we're doing this shit again.
God, stop. No. This man does not need another woman in his life.
He's got two already. I don't even think he realizes.
Yep.
They don't say famous. He is described as infamous. He's an ace that ended the conflict between Earth and Plant. He is a hero, but he's also, yeah, no, Atherin has some serious self-doubt.
I also want to point out that these are, that's a name that name, the Red Flash. He didn't have that in the original show.
No,
or
he did not.
Recording media.
These
are new to this game.
You know,
him, Kira, and Shin
all got unique titles to set them apart.
Each
in
got a Yep.
You know what? They work. Like, they... And to be honest, I'm kind of surprised they didn't give them unique titles in Seed slash Destiny, because... I mean, in Seed, Atherin and Kira are famous by the end of it. Especially with the Freedom and the Justice.
Yeah.
Okay, Orb is a third party. Yeah, are they going to talk about the Strike? And I don't mean Strike Freedom. I mean Strike Gundam.
Yeah.
That was developed by Orb against their neutrality treaty. Orb walked that line so fucking thinly, it was ridiculous. All this before the Astrays were built. And just paying. Yeah, I know what she's paying. Let's all go.
No.
And no one's arguing. Oh, God.
I think Angie would argue.
No, she's not allowed to argue. And she's had enough of that talk.
Karius, shut up.
It's got 10 of them looking for a home.
I'm sure need that.
At least there's somewhat of a relationship starting to form between some of them.
Yeah, that's good. At least some of them don't have their heads shoved up their own asses.
Oh, they hate them. They hate most of my group, despite not even knowing them.
Yep.
Like I said, they would probably get along very well with Setsuna and Alleluia. Let's see this last intermission from 9 and see what's going on here. Oh! Ooh! 9 has decided she set her sights on Atherin Zala.
Oh no.
I have been analyzing her face. Confused, Atherin. I do not know the definition of... a good guy. So, oh. She's still trying to hook up Avi.
Of course.
Alright then, carry on. Atherin.
Now that she said sisters.
I think that might have been a translation error. But we'll keep that in mind.
Might be how she's just referring to any of her girl in the team.
But also, his reaction and her reaction is great. Fucking Atherin.
He's not even trying.
To be honest, okay. Context for Atherin, he does like to tinker with machines.
Right.
He built a little bird for Kira. That's where the mascot for Seed Destiny and Seed.
Okay.
I have come to understand what. Atherin, you have an enormous problem with women.
He has no idea.
9, you have no idea. Kigali and Lunamaria. Ugh. I love his face!
That face. That man has seen things. That man wished he hadn't.
That man has women trying to kill him. Sure, I overwrite the right file. Yep. But with that, I am going. Wow. That was a 13 hour stream. But you know what? I expected it to be longer because I need a backlog. But, yeah, so. Yeah, I'm going to end the recording there.